Honourable Prime Minister Modi, Minister Gurbani, Your Excellencies, Honourable Guests. It is an honour to be here today at the 9th Vibrant Gujarat Global Summit. And next to being on an official mission, I have also to admit that I fulfilled a long-standing dream, experiencing the beauty of India with my own eyes. And what pleasure it has been to visit your beautiful, colourful and vibrant country over the past week. It has been, and it is, a fascinating visit and also productive visit. Yesterday, I had the pleasure to visit Gandhi Ashram, very close by, beautiful state of Gujarat, and this historic and serene place made me feel humble, rightly so. I myself come from the Netherlands, by some considered as a little wonder, thousands of kilometers away from here. So, why do they call sometimes my country a little wonder? Well, let me explain. The Netherlands fits into the state of Gujarat 4.5 times over, and into India almost 79 times over. And yet, although geographically being small, economically we can push well both our way. The Netherlands is, for example, the second largest exporter of agricultural products in the world. And we are the world's fourth most competitive economy. And more specifically, for this country, I would like to point out that right now we are the fourth biggest investor in India. So, how has my country made such a big economic impact? And I want to give you three relevant reasons for that. First, it's the openness. Our strategic location, by the sea, means we have always focused on international cooperation. And thanks to the Port of Amsterdam, and Port of Rotterdam, Amsterdam Schiphol Airport, and the excellent logistic connection by water and land, we are the gateway to the European continent, with almost 500 million consumers. We are honored to host now more than 200 Indian companies that have chosen the Netherlands as the location of their European activities. Tens of thousands of people are employed by Indian companies in the Netherlands. Second, our ability to innovate. Last year, the Netherlands was marked second as the world's most innovative country. Thirdly, we are a very inclusive society. Cooperating with all relevant stakeholders is key in our policy network. Partnering with international in our DNA. In the Netherlands, we prefer to solve our problems by mediation, cooperation, instead of litigation. And I'm really delighted to be here today in Gujarat, in the birthplace of Prime Minister Modi. And all Dutch and Gujarati people live a long way apart, I believe that we have a lot in common. We both have a keen enterprise spirit that we share over centuries. More than 400 years ago, the Dutchman Peter van den Broeke established the first Dutch trading post here in India, and in fact, here, right here in the state of Gujarat, in the city of Surat. And today, we still have a very busy, lovely trade and investment office right here in Kambira. Because state connects. So it's important to make trade flows as smooth as possible. And therefore, the chairman of the Central Board of Customs of India and I signed a letter of intent this week in New Delhi to further the customs treaty between the Netherlands and India. Crucial to further trade facilitation between India and the Netherlands. So the flourishing trade relation we established already a long time ago developed now in mutual investments. Our businesses are now so intertwined that many people in India see Unilever and Philips as Indian companies. After all, they have been here for decades. And also the Dutch cemeteries in Surat and Ahmedabad are also a testament of our old age times. So our close ties also blame one more than 100 business people, 45 Dutch companies from sectors like agri-food, energy, ports, and logistics were so keen to jump me on the train. The ambitious economic reform program of India is bearing fruit. Eastern energy, startup economy, clean digital, the Ganga rejuvenation, these plans are numerous and the results have been impressive. And the Dutch company must be part of the journey. We believe we have a lot to offer to each other, especially when it comes to finding smart solutions for the big issues of our century, like the sustainable development goals. Like how to feed the growing global population with safe and nutritious food. And thanks to the close cooperation between businesses and universities, Dutch agriculture and horticulture is hyper innovative, productive, and very efficient. Prime Minister, you once said, we want, we progress together, we think together, we resolve together. And together we take this country forward. And I couldn't agree more. And this is the key message on my behalf also of the summit today. We need to work together. We can't achieve everything on our own. And this doesn't only apply to the people of India, but it also applies to the cooperation of our countries. Together we can take the Netherlands and India forward and achieve our common sustainable goals. Together, we can bolster existing relationships, forge new connections, and make plans for a sustainable future. So let's build on these age-old ties that were born here, right in this state of Gujarat. I wish you all a very inspiring, successful, and vibrant summit. Netherlands, or Parat, Ti Gospi, Amesa Kami, Yap Rahengi. Thank you so much.